This Fuji X-T30 tutorial was made possible by our friends at B&H. Shop B&H online or at the store, because at the store, they have candy.
Hey guys, Omar here, and this video is for anyone too lazy to read the manual. In this video, we're going to show you how to set up your Fuji X-T30, and believe it or not, you should start with the app. And the reason is, once you put a battery into your camera, the first thing it's going to ask you is if you want to hook up to a phone, and it's actually really nice to transfer your photos to your phone. You can always do that later, but you should probably, it's easier if you do it first because it gives you kind of like a little barcode that you can scan. So get the app. 2 stars. Come on, Fujifilm. Step 2, put a battery in, following the orange with the orange. Step 3, insert a memory card into the conveniently located slot. And no, if you ever want to take it out, you just have to use the spring-loaded shooting mechanism thingy. Pa-tow. Okay, those of you new to the Fujifilm system, here's how the menu system works. Basically, there are categories, and then you'll see these little squares. The first category is image quality, and it has 3 pages. That's what the little 3 boxes there. Next one has to do with any focus. The one after that is how to set up the camera, anything that has to do with the camera. Flash, which is the most ignored if you're not shooting any flash. And new to the Fuji X-T30 is a very extensive movie setting menu that has 4 pages. The little wrench is a setup menu, and this has a lot of submenus. For example, if you go to button dial settings, there are actually 2 pages, and at the top you can see how many pages there are in any of those menus. Like for example, screen setup has 3 pages. And the last menu is grayed out because you haven't set up your My Menu yet. Okay, so the first item I always take care of, you hear that? You hear that? You hear that? I don't like any sounds on my camera, so the first thing I do is I go to sound setup, and what I'll do is I'll turn off the little beep that goes on the camera, so I'll take care of that. The next thing I'll take care of is the shutter sound. Now that doesn't mean this. That's not the shutter we're talking about. We're talking about if you shoot in what's called electronic shutter. Electronic shutter gives you a fake sound for a shutter. Listen. So you can pick your fake sound for that. But I don't like that. So I'm going to go down to the wrench sound setup menu for the sound, and I'm going to turn off the shutter volume. So now when I'm shooting an electronic shutter, you see that little ES there, it's in full silent. So you'll just see like a little flash, and no one can hear you taking pictures. Next, on the first menu, the top one, the first thing I want to make sure is that I'm shooting RAW and JPEG. Now, this is totally up to you, but I love the JPEGs that come out of the Fuji system, but I like to have my RAW files, and RAW files, for those of you that don't know, are sort of negatives, where you can sort of change a lot of things after the fact. I like having those in case I'm not so happy with what happened with the JPEG. I can edit my RAW files. For those of you that are more casual shooters or are used to just shooting JPEG, you could leave this at fine. But what I like to do is fine plus RAW. Now note, you need software to sort of manipulate your RAWs, or you can do it in camera, which is cool. So if you shoot a RAW file like this, let's shoot this picture here. If I hit play and I just photographed here, what's cool is you can go to RAW conversion. So since you shot that picture in RAW, I can go to RAW conversion and actually change the film simulation. If I wanted to make this black and white or change the film simulation, you can process the RAWs in camera. Change it to fine and RAW, even if you don't use the RAWs. Next, on this image quality menu, a lot of the menu items on Fujifilm cameras can be found listed here, but they could also be found in other places, like for example, something called the quick menu, or in swipe features that later we'll add, or also on buttons and dials that you can assign. So I'm not worried about most of this stuff because I'll be changing that later. I'll show you all this. See, this is how to manipulate the image quality, and there's a lot of options that you can play with. But right now we're not gonna worry about that. We're trying to set up the camera. Next, AF-MF. The first thing I always change is the number of focus points. I like to have the full array of focus points, so I go to the 117 and I'm like, give me all 425, please, thank you. So that's all set up. My AF mode that I most commonly use is single point. AFC custom. This is how your camera behaves with continuous motion. One is like a general purpose one, but I feel that that one actually struggles the most. I like number five because number five is the most aggressive at like looking, finding, grabbing, and tracking subjects. So I usually keep it at five, unless there is any kind of motion that passes in front of something else. So if you're shooting a soccer game of your kids, I like number two because it will stay locked on and will ignore anything that passes in front usually. So two or five, let's leave it at five for now. And by the way, that's only if you're switching to continuous focus over here. Right now we have it on single focus, but I'll get to that a little later. Store autofocus mode by orientation. For example, if I turn that on, let's just say on, if I move my focus point over to the right, well, if I turn the camera, the focus point goes back to the middle. And then when I turn my camera back, the focus point goes there. So it will remember the orientation of the camera. I don't usually use that because I like to touch focus for anything really quickly, or you could just move the focus point using touch or the little joystick here, autofocus. Okay, AF plus MF. This is one of my favorites, so I'm gonna turn that on. So now you can see here at the bottom, AF plus MF is on. And what that is you can half hold your shutter, and then on your lens, you can, if you half hold the shutter, you can actually manually focus while having autofocus. So I like having that option on. Everything else here, I leave to default. Now on page three, touchscreen focus, autofocus. You can change, this is an example of where you can change things in the menu, but believe it or not, these four changes are actually here, this little button. So if I want to change my focus to area, that means I pick an area. If I want it to have off, touch won't work for focus. So that's an example where something is in the menu, but also right on the screen. Usually I leave that to autofocus. Okay, in the camera menu, one out of two, I leave everything here the same. Drive setting is if you want to change the particular settings for each thing. Like for example, here on your dial, your mode dial, you have advanced one. Well, here is where you would find the things for that. So advanced one filter, let's just say I want that to be the toy effect. Now, if I turn the dial to advanced one, then it'll always be the toy effect. And you can see that at the bottom. I've never used this option before, so forget that. So that's the drive setting right there. So here, high burst is always 8 frames a second right there. If I go to continuous low, you can actually go to drive setting, and in continuous low, you can change what you want your number of frames to be, 5, 4, or 3. I leave it on 5. This bracket setting, you can change, bracketing means you usually take 3 shots of something. And so you could change what you want to bracket. Pop, pop, pop. What are the 3 pictures you wanna take? Do you wanna take 3 different film simulations? Do you wanna take 3 different white balances? Okay, flash will ignore because you obviously need a flash, and you should never ever use this flash. See my videos on that. All right, for movie really quickly, there's 2 ways you could do movies on the Fuji X-T30. The quickest way, if you're a beginner, is just flip your dial to the movie setting and click this auto here. Now the camera will take, if you hit the shutter now, the camera will just start recording and it will take care of everything for you. It'll take care of autofocus, it'll take care of shutter speeds and exposure. So just use the auto if you want to take videos right away. Now what's funny is this totally depends on your level of videography skills, so I'm not gonna dive deep into this. All this is like really advanced video features, so those of you that bought the Fuji X-T30 for video features, this is not the video for you. For now, let's just set up the camera. Next, a big one, button dial settings. Button dial settings is how you can customize all the buttons to fit your needs. I'll show you what I do, but don't do what I do. Do what you do. Now, you can either go to the wrench and button dial settings, or you can hold the display back button right here. If you hold the display back button, you're gonna get all the little functions that you need. Now, the one I'll talk about first are these little swipes. Now, with the Fuji X-T20, we were able to customize the D-pad as an up, left, down, right button. I set my swipes to be the same as my Fuji X-T20's directional pad. Oh, by the way, before I go on, you notice it says touch function is off. That means these swipes won't work unless we turn touch function on. Now, you would think that option is under screen setup, but it's not. It's under button dial settings, and you have to scroll all the way down to touch screen settings. Then you scroll down to the third option, and you just have to make sure your touch a function is on. Now, if you swipe, oh, I love it so much. The swipe function is so great. So now if we come back to this, I'm gonna set them to what I usually have them set to. My swipe up is usually my AF mode. So now if I swipe up, you can see that you can actually pick your focus mode. So single point or a zone, which is good for motion. So there I can change that. My left, I leave as film simulation. My right is my white balance, and my down, I'm gonna set to none just to show you that we can have nothing down. Now you can see if you swipe, you can change your white balance. So you can change that there and so on and so forth. But you can set these to whatever you want. Okay, for my function one, I make that my playback button. And the reason is I like full right-handed control. If I take a picture, I don't like to reach across the camera and try to hit the play button. The other cool thing is if you hit it a second time, it will turn on the transfer mode. Watch, if I take a picture, oops, it's on movie mode. Idiot! If I take a picture and I hit my playback button, it will play the picture back. But if I hit it again, it will ask, hey, do you want to transfer that image? And you can hit OK and it can go right to your phone. So I like that little shortcut. Once for play, two for let's transfer that photo. Okay, my AEL button is actually my autofocus on. So now if I hold this button, this becomes my focus. But now I'm a back button focuser, so I want to shut off the focus on there. Now, those of you new to back button focus or don't know what the heck I'm talking about, some photographers like to focus with the button on the back instead of the shutter. And the reason for that is usually if you like to pre-focus on a spot. So what you want to do is decouple the exposure and the autofocus. You want to take autofocus off this button. That way you can pre-focus on something and let go, and then you just kind of have to wait. You know you'll be focused. The camera doesn't have to refocus. But do as you will, I'm gonna change mine. And so what that means is I need to go back to button dial settings and I need to say shutter AF. Now I usually turn the shutter completely off so that it doesn't autofocus. However, I do like to walk around if I do street photography and focus shoot just with one finger. Because if you notice, it's hard to focus and then shoot using a one-handed, you know, it's very awkward to actually try to push this button and then fire. So for my button dial setting shutter AF, what I'm doing is for autofocus single, I've been leaving it on, and for continuous, I've been leaving it off. So now if it will focus if I hit the shutter, but if I switch to continuous, it won't focus there. I can actually, and the camera you can use in continuous focus just like you use single focus. It works totally the same. So now I have my back button focus available. But if I'm doing some street photography, I can quickly turn this to S, and now I can half hold the shutter. Ooh, sepia! How did that happen? By the way, one of the negatives of touch is sometimes it just changes itself. Okay, moving on. Now this one I've changed the FEL button, which is this one here. That one I've actually changed to be my ISO button. And the reason for that, the change of ISO there, is complete habit. Habit with my Fuji X-T20. Because the Fuji X-T20's front dial is not programmable. It barely does anything. But the Fuji X-T30 now, the front dial is a little bit more useful. So my recommendation is if you wanted to make ISO a button, I pick this one. I like using the wheel here to change my ISO instead of going up and down like this, which is annoying. I like using the wheel. So that's why my ISO is next to this wheel. For a time there, I actually had the wheel. If I push it, you can actually make the wheel be ISO, but I made it the button because I actually like the little zoom feature by pushing. Let me show you how to change the front to be ISO if you were so inclined. So the rear dial, I leave the same. And if you notice, the front dial is not listed on here, which is weird. So to change the front dial, all you have to do is hold it down. So let's hold down the front dial, and what you'll get is this little screen. So if you see, if I push the front, you can actually pick the front dial to change ISO or to change the f-stop, the aperture. So right now here it is changing the aperture. And if I click it again, you could see it's changing the ISO. I don't love going through, I wish ISO could be the only option, but you by default have to have the first one be either shutter speed or aperture. I wish I could erase that and just make the front one ISO, but it's okay, beggars can't be choosers. You could even make it exposure compensation. So if I set exposure compensation to C, then if you push the front, you'll see actually three options. Oh, Q menu push. Drinking game. So now you can see if I push the front dial, it can actually go through three different options. It can go through exposure compensation, and you can raise or lower your exposure. But what's the point of that? Really, these cameras are great because we have these awesome dials. So never use that, okay? Okay, going back to screen setup, the other thing I like is if you go to screen setup and you scroll to page two, here on page two, you'll see display custom settings, and basically that gives you a long checklist of four pages of what you want to see on the screen. Like for example, if I check framing guideline and electronic level, well now you can see I have a little grid, like a little framing grid on there, and I also have a level which goes back and forth. I don't know if you could see it, I'm so sorry. Oh, there's an accidental touch. Touch is so great. Next, I go to power management, and I usually carry about five batteries with me, so I like the performance to be boosted. I go to boost mode. It should be beast mode. But I put it on boost mode so I get the most out of my camera. It does drain your battery a little bit more, but if you have extra batteries, then go for it. Save data setting. I shoot with like three different Fuji cameras, so I like to change the name instead of being the default. I like to change that to XT30 or something with 30 on there so that I could just see from the file name that it's my camera. You see? So Omar Gonzalez 30. That works. Next, if your eyes are going on the screen setup menu on page two, you can make the large indicators now. You can pick the large indicator mode of the LCD and the EVF. They are on two different pages, which is a little annoying, but basically I'll show you the LCD one. So you might want a large display on there. The only issue is you're going to lose out on some of your information. You see like all this like little stuff comes back. So what I like to do is keep it small on the LCD, but on the EVF, I like to keep it large in there because everything is so tiny in here anyway. It's so small, you can barely see anything. You see that? All right, so to me, the camera is pretty set up. The only thing I would customize is two other things. One is what do I have on my Q menu, my quick menu? Now, I already did a video on this, but this button placement here may have you seeing this screen a lot. Now, Fuji has even acknowledged that they're going to come out with a firmware update that lets you turn this button off because you may get annoyed by just continuously looking down at your camera and being like, oh, hello, quick menu. So the two things I would change is I would set up my Q menu, and then the other thing I would switch is this first one, which are called your custom settings. Basically, you get seven different things that are set up. So your camera can be set up seven different ways, and then you can go through them really quickly. Okay, to set up your Q menu, all you have to do is hold down the Q menu for a little while and it will show up, and now it has all blanks. So you could get rid of whichever you don't want. Like for example, this D ring, I never use that. So you push this little indicator and now you can go through with what you use the most. And something I like to put there right away is face detection. So I'm just going to show you this one because you can play around what you like the most. But now, if I come to the Q menu, well, you can use them different ways. You can actually touch them. So there I have my face detection or eye detection set. Or you can touch them and use the wheel. You can touch them and use the joystick. You could forget touching them and just be like Q and use this dial here. Now, some of the settings, like for example, my ISO, which I change here, let's say I change it to ISO 400. Well, I do like it on the Q menu as well, so I could see what the ISO is at a glance. So although I don't change my ISO on the Q menu, I like seeing it. I like seeing that I'm shooting RAW. I like seeing that I'm shooting JPEG large, and I like seeing that my white balance is at auto. So now remember, you can change stuff three different ways on your Fuji. You can change on your Q menu, which means now I can change my white balance to what I want here. Number two, you could use the little swipey swipe, or the slowest and dumbest way is you can go to image quality and go down to white balance and then go across, and then you have it there as well. So a lot of things you can do three or even sometimes four different ways on your camera. Okay, that should get you started. If you want to know how to shoot with the dials and all that kind of stuff, I'll link up an old video from the Fuji X-T20 which shows you how to shoot with your Fuji camera using the dials, and especially if you're coming from another camera. All right, guys, hope that was helpful, and I'll see you guys next time.